Well, folks, as you can see, the sink is coming right along here. I have finished the supply lines and the tailpiece for the drain is in. There you can see that that's in place where it's supposed to go. And now, what I need to do is put the stopper assembly in. So what we want to do here goes like this. Take the piece like this and the plastic nut that was on the end of the tailpiece slides in like that. That goes right in there. Now I'm not going to put that in tight yet because I need to take and put the actual stopper assembly, see the hole in it, that fits in here like this, so that when you pull it up and down, it works like that. So what I need to do first is put my assembly in there. And then I can tighten it down. It will be connected. We hope. This ball has to be relatively tight because you don't want water leak through there when it's the water flows down through there. It's not there all the time, of course, but still you don't want it to be a problem. And yeah, again, you snug it up. You want it to be able to move. Not real easy because you don't want the stopper to go up and down on its own. It's only when you work the lever. And if you look here, see if I got it right or if this will make me a liar, you can see that when I pull, the stopper goes down. When you push on the lever, the stopper comes up. Oh yeah, we don't need this little piece of protective plastic on here. No, this isn't green. It's silver like the rest, see? So we'll get rid of that. Now, what we need to do here next is we need a control for the stopper assembly. That would be this piece. And of course that fits right into the back of the faucet like this. It slides down into the back here. Such as that. And then we need to connect that to this connecting piece. This slides over that like that. Actually, I'm getting ahead of myself here. This flexible piece of metal, first piece goes on like that. Then we pick a hole. I'll just pick the middle one for now, see if that works. And then you put the flexible piece on just like that. Then all we've got to do is take this. Okay. And slide it in the hole here. Just like that. And then tighten this nut down here to hold it in place, so that when I pull on it, oops, it pops out. Didn't quite get that right, I guess. Let's try that again. And of course, when all else fails, you can always read the directions, right? The other way. Maybe I have it backwards. Don't think so, but no, yeah, it has to be that way. Because otherwise you couldn't get the The nut tightened here would be against the back of the sink. So we'll slide it in a little more. There we go. Now we've got it. Now we've got it where it needs to be. Just needs to be. I didn't have it on far enough. Now we'll tighten this down and see if that makes a difference. I have to use my wrench on that. But you get the idea here. You put this in, and then when you pull up on your stopper assembly, it closes your thing, your stopper in the sink, and then when you push down on it, it opens it back up. So that's the idea, to finish that off, and then this is completely ready to put into the vanity. Stay tuned.